Veronica Post. I'm the mayor of Altus, Arkansas.
And a lot of people say we're this neat little charming town tucked away, and we're like a secret. We're located in the foothills of the Ozark Mountains, and we have beautiful scenery,
and I'm excited to show you around town.
Did you want to refer to your notes? That probably makes a lot of sense to you, that page.
It makes absolute sense, and if you take this page away, then I'm going to cut your hand off.
My name is Jim Yaple. The owner of this establishment, PJ's Fina. Well, of course, our concerns are that, you know, this kind of runs smooth and we don't interfere with our normal, especially our normal heavy loads.
Here's the dining room.
A little different than Dallas. Quite a little different, so.
We're at the Circle M. That's this proud Circle M. An odd fusion of hair salon, grocery store, and Phillips 66 gas station. Let's go inside and see who's there.
Would you ever live anywhere else, or have you ever lived anywhere else?
No, I haven't, and no, I wouldn't. Altus kind of grows on you. It's like a...
like hair?
Yeah.
Who's the best? Any fights ever break out over Domino's?
Everybody keeps saying there are no hillbillies in this town, but I know there are hillbillies in this town. That mayor knows it too.
I plead the fifth.
We're at Kelts now. Who owns this?
Dan and Jan McMillan are the proprietors and owners.
Just Dan. Dan, do you mind if I get you on camera real quick? This is Dan. And this is Dan Salper. Dan, what's your name? Tom, right?
Tom.
Hi, Tom.
What kind of crowd do you get in here?
It's pretty diverse.
Mm-hmm. We get everything from young people just of age to people who can barely hobble in.
Okay.
I'm Matthew, folks. I'm the cellar rat. I'm an albino cellar rat. That's because I never see the light of day. I'm always in the cellar.
Okay, wonderful. That's good to know.
I'm a lonely person now.
What do you do back there?
Taste wine. I can drink wine, and I filter wine.
Mm-hmm. Is that what these are, filters?
And this little arm right here tells me that I'm going 35 liters a minute.
This is Earl. And Earl, you built this all yourself?
Oh, no, I had a lot of help.
You did? So this is where they fill the bottles. This takes a crew of how many?
About 8 people to fill the bottles.
In national competition, the town wineries are award-winning wineries. My husband is one of the winemaking families, and we have hopes that our son will learn that tradition. And that's a fifth generation winemaking family.
I think our farm might be a perfect example. The small family farms, how they exist now. We got about 58 and a half acres, 20 acres of grapes, and the rest of it's pasture and woods. This is my wife, Janet, so she doesn't want to talk.
Tell me, how long have you been married?
20 and a half years.
How long have you been together?
Yeah, we lived here in this community all our life. I mean, I was born here and she was born over here on the edge of the mountain someplace.
Albert dated me. He wanted to date me because I had a brand new Camaro. He just wanted good transportation, is all he wanted.
Oh. I'm Justin. I'm 18. I'm a repairman. I fix electrical motors.
He pulls his shirt off. He's going to get in the shower. I'm thinking, yo, maybe this beer in here. And I go, oh my
it's
God.
Huge.
Do you mind tattoos? On your boys?
Oh, right? Yeah, I did. And then I just kept one and kept one.
She had a sign for me because I was on the 17th.
How long have you had it? Like a year?
2 years.
How old is this house?
It was built somewhere between 1882 and 1889. And my grandfather was born here in 1889.
What do you call this room?
This is our living room.
Living room?
Yeah.
What about the bathroom?
Oh, the bathroom.
Let's got to work around.
Wait your turn.
Well, if everybody's going somewhere, for instance, on Sunday mornings to church, it gets pretty hectic. But if you run everybody in, start early enough in the morning, you know, get on a schedule. And you got to worry about hot water, too.
The four kids. And what are the four kids' names?
Ryan, Justin, Kane, and Braxton.
And who's in here?
Kane and Braxton.
Kane?
I'm Kane.
And Braxton? How do you say your name?
Braxton.
Braxton? How old are you, Braxton?
Can you tell them what your name is?
Braxton.
Braxton what?
Braxton Woodward.
How old are you?
3.
Braxton? Who's the president?
George W. Bush.
What do you think of George W. Bush? You like him?
Yeah.
Who's the Secretary of State?
Colin Powell.
Is that right?
Yeah.
We have stories that we have to tell him. He has snow monsters, light monsters, and every kind. So I just have to make up stories and tell him everything.
Paris is in talks to star in a new reality show for Fox inspired by Green Acres.
So which one's the oldest one?
Very hot.
Mm-hmm. What do you think would happen if they moved into your house?
That would be just fine.
I don't. Can't really tell you. But I think I could manage.
You think you can handle yourself?
I think I can handle it.
Kane, do you think you can handle yourself?
What do you mean by that?
How do you think Justin and Kane would react to having them in the house like sisters?
Oh, I think they'd love it.
They'd probably get a bang out of it.
Yeah. They simply would love it.
If these girls were moving to your house, what would you expect from them in terms of keeping up the house?
Well, to pick up after themselves, not leave stuff laying around. That is my, I don't like stuff being left around.
Think a little bit about everybody else also. Can't be too self-centered.
How do you think you'd treat them?
Depends on how they treat me. Mm-hmm. I mean, if they're nice to me, I'll be nice to them. But if they're like little snotty bitches, I mean, paybacks are hell. Living hell.